Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are discussing module 5, session 6, that is the concept of hashing. So previous session we seen discussed with hashing, what kind of the hashing techniques we have, and what are the advantages, and what is the mean by hashing table we see. Now this session we are going to discuss with the collision resolution of resolution techniques. So what is the collision? First we have to discuss the what is mean by collision. If x and x2 are the two different case, it is possible that h of x is equals to h of x2. This is called as a collision. Means two are the equal, then that is called as a collision. Means two are the similar, that is called as a collision. Collision resolution is the most important issue hash table implementation. So collision resolution is the most important issue of hash table implementations. So in this, secondly, choosing a hash function that minimize the number of collisions and also hashes uniformly is the another critical issue. So those are the first one is the separate chaining, that is called as a open hashing, and second is the linear probing, that is called as a open addressing or closed hashing. So for third one is the quadratic probing, and fourth one is the double hashing. So these are the four types of techniques for the choosing the hash function. So for the collision resolution techniques. So now we are going to discuss the separate chaining or open hashing technique. So separate chaining is the one of the most common used collision resolution technique. It is usually implemented using a linked list, that means a linked adjacent linked list. And in separate chaining, each element of the hash table is the linked list. To store an element in the hash table, you must insert it into a specific linked list. If there is any collision, that is two different elements have a same hash value, then store both the elements in the same linked list. So here is the, we can show that different keys. So different keys with respective of different items with separating the each item in different values. So here is the 0 to 11 means n number, that is we can allocated each element key different items. So next one is a linear probing. In open addressing, instead of in a linked list, all entry records are the stored in an array itself. So that is called as a linear probing. When a new entry has to be inserted, when a new entry means a new a value integer inserted, the hash index of the hashed value is computed, and then the array is examined, starting with the hashed index. So if the slot at the hashed index is unoccupied, then the entry record is inserted in a slot at the hashed index, else it is proceeds in some probe sequence until it finds an unoccupied slot. So continuation of a linear probe, the probe sequence is the sequence that is followed while traversing through the entries. In different probe sequences, you can have a different intervals between the successive entry slots or probes. When searching for an entry, the array is scanned in the same sequence until either the target element is found or an unused slot is found. So here is this indicates there is no such key in the table. So for example, when we are searching any entry in the array, so array can scan sequence until either the target element is found or not. So if that indicates there is no such key in the table, the name is open addressing. refers to the fact that location or address of the item is not determined by the hash value. Now we are going to discuss with the what kind of function means what kind of index we are using for the linear probing technique. So linear probing is when the interval between the successive probes is fixed usually to 1. Let's assume that the hashed index for a particular entry is the index. The probing sequence for the linear probing will be index equals to index hash table size. So index equals to 1, index equals to index plus 1 hash table, we have to show like that. So increasing the value. So now we are going to discuss with the third technique, that is called as a quadratic probing. The quadratic probing is similar to the linear probing, and the only difference is the interval between the successive probes or entry slats. Here, when the slat at a hashed index for the an entry record is already occupied, you must start traversing until you find an unoccupied slat. So thirdly, the interval between slats is computed by adding the successive value of an arbitrary polynomial in the original hashed index. So the function what we are using, the quadratic probing, let us assume that hash index for an entry index, and at the index there is an occupied slat. So the probe sequence will be follows. So the probe sequence is index equals to index hash table size, that is index equals to index plus 1 square. So at the same time, hash table index is equals to index plus 2 square. Like that sequence, when we are increasing, then square also increasing. Now we are going to discuss the double hashing. So double hashing, what? Why we need to study the double hashing? What is the important compared to the previous one? So double hashing is similar to linear probing, and the only difference is the interval between the successive probe. That is the previous one also same thing. But here the interval between the probes is computed by using the two hash functions. See, previous one what we are discussing, three techniques, it is the only single hash function we are using. But in the double hashing we are using, here interval between the probe is computed by using the two hash functions. So that is the importance of double hashing. And next one is, let us say that the hash index for an entry record is an index that is computed by one hash function, and the slat at the index is already occupied. So here is that function is an entry record is an index that is computed by one hash function, and the slat that index is already occupied. So this is a very, very important thing. You must start traversing in a specific probing sequence to look for the unoccupied slat. So the probing sequence will be shown next slide. So here is the probing sequence is consider index equals to index plus 1, index h, that is how we are going to calculate the indexing. So previous one what we are showing here. See, even linear and everywhere we are index plus 1 square, but here is also index plus 1 like this, even item wise. But here we are, what we are showing in a double, see, it is entirely different. So index plus 1 into index h value, header value. So hashing. So that is the main importance of double indexing. So in this present session, what we are discussing mainly probing collision resolution techniques. So collision what is the collision? Collision means the similarity of x1 and x2 values. So that is called as a collision. We have to go for the main issue is the resolution technique. So that overcome by using the collision resolution techniques. So first one we discussed the separate chaining technique, open that is called as a open hashing or open separate chaining. So secondly, linear probing, open addressing or closed hashing, and thirdly quadratic probing, and fourthly double hashing. These are the four important collision resolution technique. So this is a very important concept for the even external exam point of view. So this is the about of collision resolution techniques. So now next we are going to talking about the static and dynamic hashing techniques, how that performance we can evaluate, we can see that one. So thank you very much.